Hey Densifarians, welcome back to my channel. So today let's talk about a few different sea animals. I'll be sharing some facts that are known about every single one of them, so let's get started. Alright guys, so let's begin, okay? Let's take a look at this one right here. I think this is actually a sea turtle, a 3D puzzle. So do you guys know that sea turtles, they actually go onto the land, like the beaches, to lay their eggs? And when the baby turtles actually hatches, they will actually return to the sea on their own. Okay, so you can see we have a sea turtle right here. Let me just put in the head. Okay, it can be done quite easily. And we have two flippers. So this one will go right over here, while the other one over here. So this is our sea turtle. Looks really nice. Okay, so sea turtles, they basically go onto the shore to lay their eggs. Yep. Alright, next up, let's take a look at another sea animal. Okay, I think this is actually a fish, which is known as the clown triggerfish. Do you guys know any facts about the clown triggerfish? I mean, if you know, let me know down below. I'll tell you some facts after we have assembled this, okay? So let's go. Okay, so you need to put this on. So this is basically the body and the tail. And here's the flippers. I think this one is really hot. Let's try to put this on the other side. Okay, I think I managed to put it in. Now for the other flipper. To press it in really hot. So this, it's a beautiful ocean fish. I must tell you guys, it looks really beautiful. You can see plenty of patterns on its body. Let me share with you some facts about this wonderful fish. Okay, let's put this on this little stand that it comes along with. Okay, let me just put this right up here. So basically, clown triggerfish, they are very popular, you know, among aquarium keepers. So they are very popular to keep as like pet fish. When they lay eggs, they actually lays like 10 of thousands of eggs. Yeah, very, very incredible. And they actually have a poisonous dorsal fin. Okay, they are predators. They feed on like streams and literal sea animals. Okay, so let's take a look at other sea animals right over here. Okay, I think we have a couple of really cool sea animals. So let's put this together. I think what we have right here is actually an orca, which is also known as a killer whale. You guys know what it is actually known as a killer whale? Okay, so basically they are known to be able to take down even like large whales on their own. So they are known as killer whales. I mean, they are known as orcas as well. So yeah, we got this figure. It's a 3D puzzle. I thought, you know, this figure is not like the best figure for collection, but I think it's really fun. And yeah, I think you guys might be really interested to see them. The next one is actually an emperor penguin, so let's fix this together, okay? So let me just try to fix this. I think this is the body. Did we miss out a piece? Should be on the other side. So that's the body of the emperor penguin. So emperor penguins, they actually live in a large herd, in a large flock, I mean, and they are the largest species of penguins around, way larger than other species of penguins. Okay, they are beautiful when they grow up. You can see that they various different colors when they were younger. The colors are a bit more bland. It is just like black and white and gray when it comes to the small little penguin chicks. Okay, so let's move on. We have a walrus right over here, I think. So let's assemble this. Let's assemble the body first, followed by the head, and lastly the tail. So the walrus, as you guys know, it actually has plenty of blubber, which means fats. The fats help to protect it from the cold because they live in very, very cold temperatures. And these two turtles, like what I've mentioned in my previous videos, these two turtles, oops, it came off. I mean, the actual two turtles, they don't come off so easily. They can actually dig these two turtles into the ocean sea floor while they dig for food, or they dig for scallops, because I think the current in the ocean is quite strong, so they have to, like, you know, anchor themselves onto the ocean seafloor. Okay, next, let's take a look at this one. What do we have right here? Okay, this is actually a polar bear. Yeah, polar bears, you know, they are huge and beautiful looking bears. Do you guys know that they are actually black in color? Their skin is actually black in color. They look like white because of their fur. But when you flip, you know, when you've combed through the hair, you can actually see that the skin is actually black in color. Very interesting. And the hair is actually not white. They are translucent. Yeah, you can actually see through the hair. When you pick them out, you know, a strand by strand, you can actually see that the hair is actually translucent. Yeah, but you know, on the whole, you know, when there are like millions of hairs on his body, they combine and they look white. Okay, so that's a very, very interesting fact that I've learned recently just now. Okay, so all these figures, I really love all these figures because I find them really educational for like little ones. But of course, I really love them because they are so fun. Okay, so next, let's try to fix this. What is this? Seahorse, guys, okay? But let's see, I think this is the body, so fixed it. And the tail, I think this part belongs to the tail, like this. And the head, not this way. This way will mean that, we actually mean that this seahorse is like, you know, abnormal. So this is how it should look like. So what I know about seahorses is that I think the male actually carries the young, if I'm not wrong. I may got it wrong, but you can see seahorses, they are really, really interesting sea animals. You can see like there are plenty of thorns on his body, and they have a very long snout, which enables them to find its prey more easily. Next up, let's take a look at this one. What do we have? I think this is actually like a great white shark, I think. Oh my goodness, I think, oh, the head is actually here, so let's put the tail in first, followed by the head. You can just slot this in. So this is basically a great white shark. The great white shark actually has a very, very good sense of smell. They are able to smell like drops of blood from miles away. Yeah, they have good sense of smell, but I don't think they have good eyesight. They can swim at pretty fast speed, and there are so many different types of sharks around. They are like hammerhead sharks, they are like whale sharks, they are blue sharks, mako shark, tiger shark, zebra shark, leopard shark, you name it, guys. Next, let's take a look at one of the largest living mammals of all time. This is actually a whale. And this, it's a grey whale. Let me try to fix this. Okay, so that's the body. Let's put on the head, followed by the tail. So what do we have right here? A grey whale. It's a beautiful one. So grey whales, they are really, really large marine mammals. Yeah, they are known as marine mammals. Okay, let's move on. This one right here, I think it's a hammerhead shark. Let's put this on. I think this can be done like quite easily. Okay. Leslie, the bottom part. So there you go, we have a beautiful hammerhead shark. So you guys know that the eyes are actually placed on the side of the head, right over here, the hammerhead. And it actually gives it a better field of vision. It is actually able to, you know, view at a wider angle, so that is really incredible. And they actually use the hammerhead to pin down its prey. So for example, they are eating like a stingray, so they will just pin it down while they feed right over here. The mouth is actually right below the hammerhead. So they will use their head to pin it down and use the mouth to eat it while pinning it down. So that is something really cool. Next, let's take a look at this. This is a bottlenose dolphin. So I think this dolphin actually comes in like various parts, so you can actually like disassemble it and also assemble it yourself. It's very fun. Okay, you can put this right back. So we have a dolphin right over here. So dolphins are basically like, I think we got the tail on the wrong side, probably. Yeah, so let's put this in. Okay, let's try this. So this is a bottlenose dolphin. So bottlenose dolphin, they are extremely intelligent sea animals. Of course, when you see them in the sea aquarium, sometimes they can actually perform tricks. They're very friendly towards humans, but I don't encourage you guys to actually visit like water parks to view them, because I feel that the dolphins should not be kept in captivity. Okay. Next up, let's take a look at the beluga whale, which is right over here. So let's piece this up together. So let's put this in. And the head right here. So this is the beluga whale. Do you guys know that beluga whales, they can actually use like echolocation to help them find its way in the ocean? And this part of the head is actually very soft and puffy. I've actually seen some people, you know, pressing the head, and they seem to be kind of like it. Yeah, belugas, they are extremely adorable animals, and they seem to be very, very friendly towards humans. I was actually watching like a video, dolphins and belugas, they were like helping humans, you know, for example, when they drop something into the sea, they are able to like go down into the sea and retrieve that item for the human, yeah, for the people. Okay, next up, let's take a look at this. We have the humpback whale. So let's put this on and slide the head in. So it actually comes with a little rod for you to like just slide through these 3D puzzle. So it actually holds the entire body together. So the humpback whale, I think, is one of the easily recognizable whales out there. So you can basically find like little bumps on his body. So it's a nice one. Okay, moving on, let's take a look at our last figure. Okay, this is, oh, not our last figure. I think we have still two more figures to take a look at. So this is a manta ray. So let's fix this. Okay, so that's the manta ray. Let's put this on. And now for the head. So this is a manta ray. So I don't have much facts about manta ray, but I can tell you that I have actually seen them, and I've swim with manta rays before. The way they swim is just simply by moving the body in a wavy manner. So they basically swim by just flapping this body in a wavy manner, and they're able to move really fast and really elegantly. Yeah, they move in a very smooth manner. Next up, we have a cowfish. So I think this is like one of the most interesting fish that I've ever seen, guys. Okay, let me put this on first. Okay, right here we have the body, and followed by the head. So the clownfish is actually a fish which I think it's really, really adorable, because it has two horns, and it always reminds me of a car. I mean, that is how they actually got this name from. Okay, so yes, let's do a quick roundup of all the figures that we have. Oh my goodness, we still have one more. Okay, this is not exactly a sea animal. It is an Arctic animal. And this, it's an Arctic wolf. Yep, Arctic wolf. So they can be found on snowy mountains, and they have very, very thick coat of fur to keep themselves warm. And of course, they like to howl as well. Okay, they feed on little animals such as rabbits. Yes, rabbits, some snowy rabbits can be found on the snowy mountains as well. So they feed on them, they hunt them and eat them. So yeah, let's just do a very quick roundup of all the different sea animals that we have in today's video. Okay, so basically we have a humpback whale, Our beluga whale. We have a great white shark.
Orca.
Our bottlenose dolphin. Manta ray. So you guys can see I'm trying to arrange them in a neat manner so that we can actually, you know, take a nice thumbnail photo of it. Seahorse. We have a cowfish. Polar bear. Arctic wolf. Emperor penguin. This is known as a clown triggerfish. Looks really adorable, I must say. I really love this. I think this has got to be my most favorite sea animal in today's video. Gray whale, nice one as well. We have a green sea turtle. I think this figure looks really nice. The paintwork looks really good. I used to have one, but the paintwork was not as nice. And yeah, we have a walrus. Last but not least, we have the hammerhead shark. So I think this should be good enough for us to take like a nice thumbnail photo, okay? I'm trying to balance this. I think it really needs that little sand. Okay guys, so thanks for watching this. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Yeah, I enjoy making these videos for you guys, and let me know what other animal videos you guys want me to make, and I'll be happy to do that, okay? See you guys in the next one. Goodbye.